What's up guys, welcome to my channel Tech Talks. In the previous video, we have talked about what is investing, what stops people from investing and the importance of investment. If you haven't yet watched those videos, click on the I button or the link in the description and watch it. So, today we will talk about how to build a good investment portfolio. All humans have dreams. Some dream of buying a beach house, some traveling the world, and some others have quirky dreams like landing on Mars. Whether your dream is legit or quirky, the point is that we need to build wealth to achieve those dreams. We tend to believe that dreams are different from reality. But if you don't have money now, it is impossible to achieve your dreams. Let me stop you right there and spill the truth. If you turn your dreams into goals and start investing towards achieving them, all your dreams can become reality, including landing on Mars. If you have followed us for a while, you may already know that investing is the best way to grow your wealth. But you may be wondering over how to go about investing. The answer to that is, build a good investment portfolio for yourself. This will not only help you diversify your investments across various asset class, but you will also have a retirement fund, be debt-free and have emergency cash. In this video, I will explain an investment portfolio, a few safe investments for high returns and a step-by-step guidance to build a good portfolio. So, what is investment portfolio? An investment portfolio can be defined as a cluster of different assets in which you have invested currently. It can include any number of assets ranging from stocks, cryptocurrency, mutual fund to PPF, bonds, gold, real estate, etc. It also includes the cash and cash equivalents that you own. The term investment portfolio is mostly a concept than a physical space. Especially in the digital world, you can think it as a roof under which your assets are parked. Steps to build an investment portfolio. Number 1. Assess your finance. Make a list of all the assets you own. Include all assets, including cash, deposits, bank accounts, etc. Then list down all your liabilities such as student loan, car loan, credit card bills, etc. You may need to be honest with yourself here. Don't put something away thinking it does not matter or I will get done with it tomorrow. The key to build a great portfolio is by assessing where you are right now. Take a courageous look at the full picture of your financial situation. Number 2. Open a retirement savings fund. Retirement could be the last on your list when you are just venturing into independently handling finances. But trust me, retirement needs to be given a priority before all else. Here is why. Our generation does not have the luxury to get a pension from our employers, and the more you save towards the retirement, the more comfortable will be your future. So, begin by opening a retirement fund such as NPS, ETF or PPF. These investments do not require you to make a large contribution towards the capital. Even if you spare a small percentage of your income towards retirement, your corpus will build itself over time with the power of compounding. Number 3. Build an emergency reserve. The pandemic that struck the globe last year has taught us one thing, that is, be prepared. Once you start putting aside money for your retirement, work towards building an emergency fund. This fund may consist of 3 to 6 month cash reserve covering your basic expenditures in a high liquid account such as bank deposit or savings account. This fund will keep you shielded from any unexpected crisis like pandemic, natural disaster, sudden unemployment, etc. Even if the chances for such events are unlikely, what harm is it to keep some money aside for time of emergency? Number 4. Choose your asset based on your risk appetite. Risk appetite is your ability to bear investment losses in return for the possibility of earning high returns from your investments. Knowing your risk tolerance level helps you invest in assets that suits your goal, timeline and personality. Now comes the question, where to invest the money? Invest in stocks, cryptocurrency, mutual funds and fixed deposits. Some of the other assets for investing includes gold, commodities, real estates, alternative assets, etc. While your house, car, antiques, etc. are considered assets, but they do not form a part of your portfolio. Number 5. Determine the asset allocation that's best for you. Now that you know where to invest, it is time to decide how much money you want to allocate for each of your assets. Splitting your portfolio over various assets at different proportion is called asset allocation. Again, asset allocation should also be done based on your risk appetite. For example, suppose you are a conservative investor, that is low risk investor. You may want to invest more in assets like fixed deposit and bonds, etc. If you are an aggressive investor, that is high risk investor, you may want to hold stocks and cryptocurrency as a major chunk of your portfolio. Moderate investors, that is medium risk investors, can consider investing in a mix of high and low risk assets. So, building an investment portfolio can be an overwhelming task for some. It may take years to form good shape, but do not give up. Keep a steady plan as you begin and stay committed to improve your finances as you go along. So there you are, guys. Hope you enjoyed. If you did, then drop a like, and if you haven't yet subscribed, click below and join us.